My fire, the one desire, believe when I say I want it that way. But we are two worlds apart.
I would have to have a walker inside of the bathroom because my wheelchair didn't fit in, and that would also be in the way of my roommate and not very conducive to my peer living situation. There was a large psychosocial aspect, especially on campus. A lot of times people would look at you and stare at you, and I couldn't tell if it was because students knew me and knew that this was a new ailment for myself or if that's how it would feel in real life. When I went out to Aldi's, Tops, I did not have this as much. I had a lot of people that were moving out of my way, asking if I needed assistance or any positivity. And I don't know if it was the younger population here on campus or if it was the unknown of me being in manual wheelchair. I know that on campus we see a lot of motorized wheelchairs almost every day, but it's weird to see someone in a typical blue wheelchair that you have to push yourself. So a lot of psychosocial aspects of people are looking at me. People think I'm different. People think that they have to help me, even though I was trying to be as independent as I could be. I was very lucky that my diagnosis didn't have me have any upper extremity problems, because I think if I did, I would have a much more difficult time doing everyday tasks. But I'm very excited to take this knowledge to help me move on as an individual for advocacy, as well as using it in my occupational therapy practice. I think the understanding of not being able to do everyday tasks, and if it's a quick onset, I couldn't do my favorite activity, which is baking cakes in a class. I had to do it while assuming. So that took away a lot of my creative liberties and my abilities because of this early onset or quick onset diagnosis that I was assigned. So it is very helpful for my mindset, and I'm excited to use it in my life.